Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Raymond. Happy birthday to you.
And many, many more.
And only two candles. Can you see it's a tractor?
Oh, a tractor.
And it's got smoke and it says, Happy 90th birthday, Raymond.
Take one.
Hey! Good job!
Too late.
Growing up a Kansas farm boy, life was mostly having fun.
We had to burn more wood than the hogs where they ate the corn. Off the cob, right? The cobs was good to start fires with. We had a big wood pile, and we have to see that it had wood. We'd go to the hen house and gather up the eggs. Of course, we walked to school, or we had ponies we'd ride sometimes.
Sometimes this old farm feels like a long lost friend.
Well, you know, I like to see stuff grow and, you know, something about working this soil. When we first started, where we didn't have money, we borrowed the money to buy a new tractor and a disc and stuff that way.
Well, I guess there were some hard times. And I'm told some years were lean.
And there were some pretty hard times into the drought years. Sometimes the note would be due, you know, and I'd sure hate to go to the bank because I didn't have the money to pay the interest. And I think twice in my life when we were starting out, the banker would say, well, I guess we can just add it on the principal.
Did you make a good choice as far as a wife, and how'd that turn out for you?
Oh, it couldn't have been better. I made a good choice, and I got a good one.
The kisses that I live for, the love that lights my way, the happiness of living with you brings me.
We had a lot of good years and some bad ones, like it is on the farm, but we've had a good life here.
Yes, and joy was just the thing he was raised on. Love is just the way to live and die. Gold is just the windy castle we feel. Blue is just Kansas summer sky.
Most of that farm equipment you saw in that, we've ridden on it at one time or the other. On the fenders, he'd always take us for rides. But probably my favorite is, of course, he's always Evel Knievel to me, because he would always take me on his motorcycle and he would go real, real fast around the yard, and then we'd go whoop, just over this little hill. But we thought it was the greatest thing. But the thing most of all that touches my heart is when he and Dad would get together and tell stories. They had the most amazing laughs. And the stories that they will tell will be forever embedded in my heart.
And then they'd get to telling stories about slaughtering a hog, and they would get so tickled that they could never finish the story. I never heard how that story came out.
We had a truckload of fat hogs almost ready to go to market. We got to talking about getting one of them butchered. Out of the blue, Raymond said, you know, we ought to butcher this hog ourselves and save a bunch of money. The following conversation ensued. Me, this is his brother Gerald. Are you saying we? Raymond, well, yeah, I'd need a little help. Gerald, have you ever butchered a hog? Raymond, no, but I've watched Dad do it. There's nothing to it.
and a bunch of guys, and they sat around while the women bowled, and they had some beer in the, or something there in the bowling alley. So they sat there all afternoon, and then when it was time to go and we're all through, Raymond got up, and instead of walking forward, he started walking backwards. So we never let him live that down. Have you been walking backward lately?
You know, Raymond? I always wondered where Michael Jackson got that moonwalk.
I never knew what it was to lose. Can you imagine?
Y'all had two undefeated seasons, right?
Till 44 I played, but we had a lot of good players. As far as I know, I'm the last one. We had one or two guys could run, really run.
Raymond played tackle next to his brother Curtis, who played guard.
Were y'all pretty good?
They didn't go through our side.
They always ran their plays on the other side?
Yeah, if they tried it, they didn't get very far.
What was the toughest team you ever played during those undefeated
seasons?
All
Burlingame up here was pretty, but they were they played pretty dirty, you know. That's the one that knocked the wind out of me that time. Dad run out on the field. He thought I was going to be die or whatever. I don't know. We just played the schools around, you know, in the county. And Osage City was a lot bigger than Linden. But we beat Osage, and boy, they couldn't take it. Turned 18 before I got out of high school. I went to Leavenworth for my physical.
So this was like your physical to go into the Army?
Yeah. And when I got home, on a bus, they brought us in to Linden. I went up and they were playing, the game was being played then. And the coach, when he saw me, the coach, he says, "Go suit up." And I played the last part of the game.
You're in the Army now.
Next, he suited up for Uncle Sam. Then on to a hard-fought win at Okinawa. So from the football field to the battlefield to the farm field, he's teamed up with wife Ann to run for 72 years. 95-year-old Raymond Goldsmith remains undefeated, just like those 1943-44 Linden Legends of the Fall.
Here at Prairie Van Casino with Ray Goldsmith. What's the big secret, Uncle Ray, to winning big here?
Well, you got to kind of shake the panel the best
shake
way
hand.
I've found.
Let me show you. Show me with your hand how you shake it. Kind of like that.
Something like that.
Well, shake it. Take it. Let's see what you win.
Okay, we'll see. Must not chuck it right.
When I was in Okinawa, I carried a BAR, they called it. It was an automatic.
Browning automatic rifle, right?
Yeah. That wasn't a good thing to be carrying in a battle because that's the ones that they wanted to knock out first because they done the most damage, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But I was lucky there. There was a few of those them suicide planes that, you know, mm-hmm. used. About every night, one or two would come to try to hit something, you know. Them guys had no way out. They spot welded them in there, them doors. There was one that I didn't go off when he got it down. I don't know, it looked like it, but it was a pretty rough area. I don't know how he got it down. But it didn't blow up. It's supposed to, if you try to land it, it was supposed to blow up, you know. But when they'd come one or two at a time, well, you could see the old radar, the old gun go up, and it just good, it just blow him out of the sky. But see, it was north and south in Korea, and they had that 38th parallel, and the Russians were on that other side, you know. And I'd went up there to the 38th parallel to take mail with a guy. And
you saw blonde-headed Russian woman, didn't you?
We just just drove up there. Or they took mail up there in the Jeep, and I just rode along to the guys that. They had the troops on each side. Our troops was on this side of the line and the Russians on the other. And they were just more or less guarded. There wasn't nothing there, no fence, I don't think. I don't remember much about that part. My buddy in the communications part, he come down and he said, Raymond, they're up there at the barracks. They're signing people up to re-enlist for 18 months. If you do that, you get to go home right away. I said to my other two guys, I'll see you later. So, it wasn't a week until we was out of there on a ship of going back home. And well, that's how come I met her. So that's another streak of luck I had. Because I went to Fort Hood to spend most of my 18 months. See, I got re-enlisted, they called it. They called a discharge in South Korea and re-enlisted to the regular army instead of being the drafted, you know.
Uh-huh.
And,
so what did you do in Fort Hood?
Well, you know, I got in the motor pool there.
Hmm.
And I worked on vehicles, and I had a brand new Jeep issued to me when we were there.
Brand new what?
A brand new Jeep.
Oh, yeah.
You were top dog, weren't you?
Well, I was kind of, we didn't overhaul stuff. But we just done the maintenance and also if anything went wrong, we could fix most stuff, you know. But I was in that, and so, I think I got my little, I got enough rating. The technician rating that I didn't have to pull no KP or no guard duty. I hated that guard duty, standing out there in the dark, and you didn't know. And I done some of that in Okinawa before the war was over. And them Japs would come out of the hills, and you're out there in the dark, and you hear a noise, and you know you don't have a good feeling. But anyway, it worked out for me. But there's a lot of things that...
Me too.
Hmm?
Me too.
Who?
It worked out for her.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it did.